Hello everyone. Hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we are going to learn a tutorial on cash flow analysis. We are going to take some examples of Google, Boxing, and Amazon and Colgate. So let's get into the nitty-gritty of the same. See, the first thing, cash flow analysis. There's a company like, you know, the Iron Mount Corp and Bronze Metal Corp. Both hypothetical companies had identified a cash position, let's say at the beginning and at the end of 2007. Each company also reported, let's say, a net income of $2,25,000 for 2007. Now, which company is displaying elements of the cash flow stress? What factors cause you to reach this conclusion? What is the importance of doing the cash flow analysis? Let me show you something. As you can see over here, in the operating activities, there is a gain on sale of equipment, the net cash flow from operating data, investing data, that is sale of equipment, proceeds from the long-term borrowing, and this is your cash flow statement. So, cash flow analysis is one of the best methods through which an investor can understand how much net cash inflow a company is generating. In this tutorial, we'll be looking at so many other details regarding this. So let's get into the first, what exactly is the cash flow? See, cash flow analysis is one of the most important analysis you need to do. So if you want to know about a company's cash flow and cash inflow and cash outflow, then in that particular scenario, you need to pay special attention to this two phrases. Cash inflow and cash outflow. In cash flow statement, these two phrases matter the most. Let's take an example and understand this. Let's say there is a company ABC and has just started a business and earned revenue in close enough to, let's say, $100. Okay, that's the revenue which they are incurring. So everything is in dollars. Just consider that 100. And as for the record, their expenses are now close enough to 60. So this is your revenue. This is expenses. And in general terms, you would say the company ABC has made close enough to 100 minus 60, that is a 40 profit as a product. However, in this case of the company ABC, it is seen that they have a revenue close enough to 100 in the year, but they have collected only 80 in that particular scenario. Then in this case, the expenses they have paid only is 50. So, and the remaining for the next year. So, if we compute the net cash flow this year, it could be 80 minus 50, that is going to be 30. So, even if the company ABC has made a profit of 40 this year, their net cash flow is just 30. So, in cash flow analysis, we will only include the cash related to the operations rather we will also include the expenses and income from the investing and financing activity. Let's do some cash flow analysis. See, cash flow analysis are divided into three parts. The first in I'll just write over here, cash flow analysis. The first is the cash flow from the operations. Then we have cash flow from investing activities. And then finally, we have cash flow from the financing activities. We'll discuss this one by one. As you can see, the cash flow from the operations, the inflows are generalization of the funds in the normal operations of the business. The outflows are again the normal operations that happens for the same, the expenses that have been incurred. Then you have the investing activities that have plants and equipments, that is sale of plant and equipment, that is your cash inflow. The long-term investments, that is the liquidation of the same so that you receive the amount in your bank, that is your inflow. And there is outflow, that is purchase of the plant and equipments, investments in long-term investments. So all are that your outflow. In case of the cash flow for the finance, you have debt issuance, common stock, preferred stock and other securities. In case of the cash outflow, there is a retirement of debt, commitment stock and preferred stock, and there's a payment of the cash dividend. Let's understand each of them on a very quick basis. There is a cash flow from the operation. In this scenario, you know, the cash flow from the operation, it means taking into account cash flow generated from the normal business operation and its corresponding to the cash outflow. There are basically two methods to calculate this for cash flow from the operation. One is the direct method, another is the indirect method to calculate this. The indirect method is used in most of the cases. This method that we are talking about, it is used in most of the cases. And here we'll look at only the indirect method for computing the cash flow from the operations. See, for the computation of the cash flow operation, before you start thinking about the cash flow statement analysis, you know, you have to look at the income statement, and you have to start with the net income. That is the first thing. You have to start with the net income. Then you need to add back any, you know, non-cash expenditure like depreciation, amortization, and so on and so forth. I mean, this is the same with any sort of like sale of assets. If there is any loss on the sale of assets, we need to add them back. If there is a gain of sale of asset, we need to deduct. And then we need to take into account any changes, that is the plus or minus change in the, you know, you can say the non-current assets. And finally, we need to include changes in the current assets and current liabilities. Let's see an example of Colgate's cash flow statement. As you can see, this is the Colgate's Palmolive cash flow statement, the net income, then the adding back all the processes, and then there is a change in the working capital, or basically current liabilities and current assets, which gives them the net cash flow from the operation as in the recent year is 2949, and that is in terms of millions. So even though Colgate's net income is 1548 in 2015, you know, it's basically, as you can see over here, from operation, which seems to be in line with the past. And if you look close in 2015, the cash flow from the operation, there is a charge of Venezuela accounting change that has contributed to close enough to 1084 million in 2015. And this was absent in 2013, in 2014 and 2013 from the cash flow. If you remove the charge of the Colgate's cash flow from the operation, will not look too exciting. Now let's see the cash flow from the investment activity. See, other than the operation, the company also invests in assets which can provide them with a greater returns. We need to find out how many cashless or, you know, activities are done during the period so that we can take them into account while ascertaining the net cash flows. See, cash inflow from the investing activity would include activities like purchasing of the, you know, long-term assets, long-term investments, or securities, or selling them, basically also providing taking loans. So though there is nothing much to be talked about here, because here there are only two things that to be taken into account. First, we need to add back all the losses while selling any long-term assets or marketable security. And this losses should be added back as there is no such outflow for the losses. Second is that in that particular case, we need to deduct the profit while selling any long-term assets or marketable security. And this profit should be deducted because there is no cash inflow for the profits of the company that has been made. Let me show you Colgate's cash flow from the investment example. This is the case of the cash flow statement from the investment example. See, Colgate's cash flow analysis from the investment activity is close enough to 685 in negative in 2015, 855 negative in 2014, and Colgate's core capital expenditure was 691 million in 2015 as compared to 757 million in 2014. So in 2015, Colgate got proceeds of close enough to 599 million from the sale of the marketable security and investments. Additionally, Colgate received, you know, 221 million from the proceeds from the sale of the South Pacific laundry detergent business. Let's now understand the cash flow from the financing activities. So in case of the cash flow from the financing activity, first there is, you know, any buyback of issuing, you know, of securities, and it will come under the financing activity in case of cash flow analysis. Borrowing, or basically, you know, repaying of any short-term or long-term issuing notes, bonds, and will also be included under the financing activity. We also need to include any dividend that has been paid, if any. And however, we need to make sure that, you know, we don't include any income or any accounts payable or accrued liability, because they would be taken into account in net cash flow from the operating activities, right? Let me show you the example for the Colgate's net cash flow from the financial activity. As you can see, this is your Colgate's from the financing activities. The Colgate's financing activity, you know, it is basically having a really consistent position in all the 3 years. Colgate's principal repayment on debt was close enough to 9181 million in 2015, and its issuance stood at 9602 in basically millions. And Colgate has a stable dividend policy. They paid dividend close enough to 1493 million in 2015 and 1446 in 2014. As a part of the share repurchase program, Colgate's buyback shares at regular intervals. So in 2015, the Colgate purchased shares of 1551 million worth of shares. So now let's see, I'll show you some of the example of iron mount versus the bronze metal case. See, let's go back to the earlier cash flow statement that we had in a very inception state that we had studied in the cash flow example. We started with the iron mount corp and the bronze metal corp had an identical cash flow position at the beginning and at the end of 2007. Each company reported a net income of 2,25,000 as we had discussed. Let me show you again the same. So we hear the iron mount and bronze metal, both companies have the same end of the year cash of 365,900 in both the scenario. Additionally, changes in the cash during the year is the same, that is 315,900, which company is displaying elements of the cash flow stress. So we note that in the cash flow from the operation is negative for basically the iron mount, okay, that is the operating 21450, that is in the negative case. And the gain on the sale of the equipment is deducted, and as this is not basically an operating cash flow, the iron mount sale of equipment is close enough to 307,350, and which contributes to the increase in the cash. So on the other hand, when we look at the bronze metal, we note that its cash flow from the operation is are close enough to strong 374,250. And they are, and seems to be really doing good in the business. They are not relying on one-time sale of equipment to generate cash flows. So with this, we conclude that the iron mount is showing signs of stress due to the low core operating income and its reliance on the other one-time items to generate cash flow. Let me show you the cash flow analysis example of Google, that is Alphabet. As you can see over here, in case of cash flow from the operations of Google, basically this is blue is for operations, orange is for investing, and this red or pink you can say for financing activity. Cash flow from the operations, Google's cash flow from operations are generated from basically, you know, the advertising revenues for by Google properties and Google network members properties. So additionally, Google generates cash through the share of, you can say, you know, share of apps, and so on and so forth. Basically, additionally, you know, they are also into the hardware products, licensing arrangements, service fees received from the Google Cloud offerings. So Google cash flow from the operations shows an increasing trend, primarily due to increase in the net income. Google's net income was close enough to, you know, 14.14 billion in 2014. This was in case of the 2014 case. 2015 case was close enough to 16.35 billion and 19.48 billion in 2016. So cash flow from the investing activity, if you see for Google's investing activity primarily include the purchase of the marketable securities and cash collaterals paid related to the security lending spends on related to the acquisitions. If you see the cash flow from the financing activities, cash flow from financing activities driven by the proceeds from the issuance of the debt and debt repayments, repurchases of the capital stocks and net payments related to stock-based awards, that is the ESOPs, you can say. And Google's cash flow from the financing activities are decreasing each year due to the increasing in the share of the repurchase. So in 2016, Google's repurchase shares worth of close enough to $3.304 billion as compared to $2.2422 around billions in 2015. Let me show you this graph again. So this is the graph of the Google's Alphabet. I hope you have got a great idea regarding the Google. Let me show you the same graph for Amazon and give you some insight regarding the same. Now this is the graph of Amazon. As you can see over here, in case of the cash flow from the operations, the Amazon's cash flow operation is derived from the cash received from the consumer, seller, developer, enterprise, and content related customers. So this is, you know, basically we, you know, note that the cash flow from the operation has been increasing steadily, you know, as you can see, and this is primarily due to increase in the net income. Amazon's net income was close enough to 241 million in 2014, 596 million in close enough to in 2015, and 2.2371 million in 2016. Let's see the cash flow from the investing activities. In case of the investment, cash flow from the investment of Amazon comes from capital expenditures, including leasehold improvements, internal use of softwares, website development cost, and so on and so forth. So the cash flow from the investing was around 9.9 billion in the 2016 case of Amazon, as compared to 6.5 in 2015. If you see the cash flow from the financing activities, it is moving down. Amazon cash flow from the financing activities basically comes from the outflows resulting from the principal repayment as a long-term debt, obligations related to capital and finance and leasing. And it was 2.9 billion in 2016 and 3.76 billion in 2015. So now let's quickly understand the final summary of the cash flow analysis. The net income is in line with the net income statement. You need to adjust for any depreciation amortization. Okay. And then you have to adjust for provision for losses on accounts of account receivable, gain on losses on sale of facility. Then you have to increase or decrease in the trade receivables, that is the changes in the accounts receivable and changes in inventories, in creditors, and cash generated from operations. Then you have the cash flow from the investing activity, which is purchase of the fixed assets, proceeds from the sale of fixed assets, and the net cash used in investing activities. That gives you finally your financing activities. That is cash flow from the financing activities. If you see the proceeds from the issuance of the common stock, that is the first part of financing activities. Then you have from the long-term debt, if you pay any dividend. And finally is net cash that is used in the financing activities. That is summary of the preceding items in the section. So let's make the final conclusion on the cash flow statement after studying this much on learning this much in case of the cash flow analysis. If you want to understand about the company and its financial affairs, you would need to look at the three statements and all the ratios you have. Only cash flow analysis would not only give you a right picture about the company. If you look at for the net cash inflow, but also make sure that you have checked how profitable the company is over the last years. So also the cash flow analysis is not that easy thing. You know, you can say that easy thing to compute. If you want to compute cash flow analysis, you need to understand more than the basic level of, you know, finance. And you also need to understand the financial terms, how they are captured in the statements and how they reflect in the income statements. And thus, if you want to do cash flow analysis, first know how to see the income statement and understand what to include and what to exclude in the cash flow statement. Thank you, everyone.